Hello, my friends. Welcome back to the Two Ponies channel with Dana and Dooley. He's exhausted. He drove 500 miles today, 501.8. Yes, he did. So I'm sitting here. I deliver in Tracy, California. Early in the morning. We got to get up at 3:30 in the morning. So I'm like winding down. I'm crocheting. I'm working on Lisa's blanket. I'm using the neck light that Nona Rosie gave me. And I'm thinking about the yarn bus. Now, there's been some questions as to why. Okay, so I'll explain why I want an ambulance. You know, people have said, oh, you need to get a school bus. No. Oh, why don't you just get an RV? No! Not again! So I have had a couple of RVs in the past. And honestly, you know, unless you get something absolutely brand new, well, they're just not made well. They are not made well. They're mass produced. And even though, like my Aunt Martha has one, it's brand new. It's beautiful. It is gorgeous, and it has inspired me to consider, you know, what my design ideas are going to be like. And it's going to last her quite a while. It's going to last her a long time because it is brand new and probably one of the better ones on the market. But still, they are not made to withstand a rollover. I mean, I've had a lot of problems with RVs, right? So I'm not going the RV route. I want something that is built tough. And no, I'm not going to do a school bus. Same thing. No. You have to start over in a school bus, just like if you were doing, you know, the hashtag van life on YouTube. If you haven't checked that out, that's quite a community. And you can see what people have done, you know, in these different models of vans. Some vans brand new, some a few years old, some older. But how they have converted those vans into their living space, amazing. Absolutely amazing. But they have to strip down the inside of that van, and they got to start with wiring and insulation, right? So here are the advantages of going with a good quality used ambulance. First of all, they're already insulated. They already are wired. They have a ton of storage, and they are built to withstand a rollover. Also, they have diesel engines in them, and I could go on and on about why I want a diesel engine. So I plan on getting, they call it a Type 3. It's a van in the front, and then you've got the box. It's not just like a van ambulance. It's got the van front end, but then there's a box there. It'll probably be 68 inches tall and, you know, standard ambulance length. And I would really like the kind, you know, that has a pickup in the front, but very few of those actually have the walk-through pass through between the cab and the box, right? So I want the pass through. I do. So, you know, as far as design goes, you know, you've got on the passenger side of the box, you've got a door, and then you've got two doors in the back, right? So imagine you're walking in that side door. Okay, so what you're looking at in front of you is the driver's side of the ambulance. Now, typically, what you've got are some overhead cabinets and a countertop, and then cupboards or cabinets, whatever, down below. My plan is to make that whole wall look like a Hoosier cabinet, because, you know, we'll have the countertop. You know, I'll probably change the look of that countertop to make it look, you know, like the counterpart of a Hoosier cabinet. And then, you know, the compartments up on top, you can paper those and put different handles on them to make it look like, you know, the cabinets. And you can put, you know, make it look like a piece of furniture. Just one big piece of kitchen Hoosier Baker's cabinet furniture as you walk in. And that's the design idea. And then when you turn to the left, you're going to have like a walkway along the front of that. And on the left will be the dinette kind of spot, right? And then behind that will be like a super twin. Not a huge bed, because it's just me and my dog. Yeah. And I plan on having, you know, a Dometic or a Coleman or some kind of stove, you know, probably two burner that I can pack up and put away. You know, I cook with cast iron. So, you know, I'll need storage for the pan and for the stove. I don't plan on having an oven. There will be a shower with a piece of the flooring coming up, and, you know, like you put in your slatted, you know, great, you know, there'll be like a shower pan underneath that piece of the flooring, and I can bring out of an upper cabinet the shower curtain to come around. And I'm gonna have some kind of water system, the kind of water system where the engine coolant actually heats the water. So, and that sprayer will be part of the sink right there, and I can also use it in the shower, and it'll come around, and there'll be magnets at the bottom to magnetize the bottom of that the shower curtain to the inside edge of the shower pan. And then, you know, when I'm done and I can, you know, let that dry and then put it back away, I can put the piece of the floor back in the shower pan, right? So it looks like my faux wood floor. So those are the things that are, you know, going through my head. The bed's going to be kept. It's not going to be up high with a big garage underneath like a lot of people like to do in the back of their vans or their ambulances. It's going to be pretty low to the ground because Dooley's 12 this year. And that poor boy, well, he's 12. And he has arthritis, and he has problems with his spine and his hind legs. My concern is that I don't get it built enough, at least usable, before Dooley's gone. My plan is to, you know, hopefully at least get it bought this year and be able to travel a little with it, even though, you know, I won't have the build out completely done or barely done this year. But it'll be livable enough that, you know, hopefully I can go some places and enjoy it with Dooley. Excuse me. So, you know, the super chats, the watching the video, or, you know, the ads over on the other channel, that's what all that goes to, all of it. Plus, I'm trying to save up, you know, for the buying of the ambulance. I still got that one in Kalispell, Montana in mind. It'll be a lot of money, but, I want to be able to enjoy this at least, you know, for a short while before Dooley's gone, because he is aging. I don't mean to get so emotional, but yeah, Dooley is aging and he will be gone. You know, there will be a day when I come on here and say, hey, you know, just to let y'all know, Dooley passed. And I want to enjoy time with him, you know, in the ambulance before he's gone. Now, it'll have, we call them bunk heaters in these trucks. They're a diesel heater. And what they do is they siphon off, like, drops of diesel out of your fuel, like on this, usually there's, you know, a diesel heater in trucks like this. This one doesn't have one. Long story. But, you know, it just, like, the heater is underneath the bunk. And it, like I said, it just, overnight, even when the engine's not running, if you turn it on the panel, it'll siphon off drops of diesel fuel and run that heater. And you can adjust, you know, the fan and the temperature, and they're just wonderful. And I'm looking at air conditioning options. Dooley has to stay cool. And if, like, I pull up it to a grocery store and it's hot out, you know, I need to leave AC going inside. And because it's a diesel engine, I can just leave the engine running, lock it up, and leave the AC going. I do that in my pickup, and I do that in these trucks to keep the AC blowing on him. But I'd like to have, you know, how, you know, a good 12-volt AC unit in the box of that ambulance, so the back, you know, can stay cool. I'm gonna put, you know, the fan above in kind of the, you know, kitchen area of it, and then another fan in one of the back windows at the back of the ambulance to keep good circulation going. So yeah, you know, a lot of reasons why I'm sticking with the Ambulance Plus. I'm not gonna worry about parking, right? I'm gonna be able to park the thing. I don't have to worry about going back east as far as, you know, height goes, because as a general rule, if like I'm pulling a trailer right now that's 14 feet tall, that's my clearance, which means I can't go east of Denver. East of Denver, you can only run trailers that are 13 foot 6 inches tall. So, you know, you run into that problem with, you know, some other vehicles. The fact that it won't take much, it's already insulated, it's already wired. So all I really need to do, just to be able to take a trip, I mean, it won't be perfect, you know, it won't be beautiful and everything won't be great, but I will be able to run air conditioning and heat. I just have to put in some kind of bed. Oh, really? Oh, really? He just stole that cup out of the front cup holder because it had my pork ribs. Sneaky thief. Sneaky Pete. Really, all I need to do is plug in a coffee maker and have a cot in it, you know, or a mattress, something, you know, to sleep on, and we can take trips in it. Something else I plan on doing, you know, some of those lights, you know, I don't want those red lights. I don't want all of those lights. So some of those lights I'll change to a clear lens, and some of those lights I will turn into like a skylight tunnel up in the top part of the bunk, so there'll be light coming in, kind of like skylights. So anyway, I've gone on long enough. I just was sitting here thinking about it, and I think, you know, people have asked me, why don't you just buy an RV, or why don't you, you know, do a bus? Well, no, I'm not going to build out a whole bus. You have to start from complete scratch. You have to completely strip it, and you got to do the insulation and the wiring, and then get your walls up, and then, you know, you just go on and on from there, right? Well, the ambulance has a lot of that hard stuff already taken care of, and they are built tough. Now, yes, and, you know, some of the major metropolitan areas, they may have low miles, but they're going to have high engine hours on them, right? Because they sit and idle, and they wait for a call. Well, you get out of those places when you go looking for an ambulance. You find a place where they don't sit and idle waiting for a call. that's what happens in the cities. That doesn't happen in all areas. So, you know, that's the kind of vehicle I'm looking for. And those diesel engines, the ones they have in those trucks, are just, they're top of the line. So that's why I'm going with an ambulance. So there's 15 minutes of rambling. How's that? Now, this video will go up Thursday morning. Friday morning, I'm picking a winner. So be sure you've commented on Monday's video. And Dooley and I are going to continue to dream about our ambulance vacation times and watch a little TV and crochet a little bit before I got to go to bed and get up really early tomorrow. Okay? Okay, I love you guys. Bye.